Alright, hello everybody, and welcome to the very first Ellen Friends Play Retro. So, yeah, I've been thinking about doing this for a long time, and I didn't really know what to call this. And this will be quick, this won't be a long, drawn-out thing. If you want to skip it, like, you know, just skip it over a little bit. But, yeah. I thought about doing this for, like, the longest time, and I just honestly, like, I didn't want to step on anybody's toes with legal shit or whatever. And for me, the idea popped in my head was, just call it Ellen Friends Play Retro, and then it will be its own, what do you call it? It'll be just its own thing down there. And it'll be kind of like, Two Best Friends Mystery Box or whatever. But for me, it'll just be something different. Like, I'm not gonna put the title of the game on top. The only reason why for earlier this video I said it's gonna be Dead Rising is because it just came out. And, yeah, no, it's just, it's something that's, like, to me, this game is really held dearly to me. And, I fucking love the Dead Rising series. This was the main reason why I bought an Xbox 360. This was the main reason. This and BioShock were two of the main reasons why I bought it. So I guess, yeah, we're just gonna... Wait, change slots? Oh, so you have different save slots too, so they updated that. Cool. Okay. I haven't played this in years, so I'm gonna put that out in the open. But... this is the game that I fucking, that I strived and I wanted to, I wanted to buy, like, day one. And I did. Dead Rising was such a, like, pinnacle for me for, like, let's say, like, YouTube, like, all this shit, like, leading up to this. And then also after, like, watching other YouTubers and everything else play games. And, yeah, no, it's just, this was a big reason, like, for going the Xbox route for me. Because I just, I loved this hey, game buddy, for what it was.
You mentioned something about research for a story.
That's right. Got a tip that something big's happening.
In a nowhere little town like that?
And this does look like
they sure
HD.
They didn't mention anything about it on TV.
Yeah, well, I'm freelance, pal. I don't make my living waiting for the TV to tell me what to cover.
And yeah, I don't know, like, just this game was just a big part of, like, my, like, of me playing this, because I had BioShock on one hand for,
here
like, the really,
is.
Like, hardcore and,
Willamette,
like,
Colorado.
Crazy,
population
like, game for what it is, and then I had this because, like,
distinguishing characteristics.
Because I have such a love for, like,
shit.
Zombies and stuff like that.
About the only thing to do in this town is kill time at the shopping mall.
And seeing how good this is and how good it plays on this, I'm gonna
gonna
just
the
see
Army?
Like maybe I'll actually make these into a series.
Looks like taking
but
a
the big thing
the
is
it's
like all that Ellen Friends Retro is just me jumping back into these old games and just doing it and just enjoying
all right,
this.
I want to get shots of the whole town before the National Guard finishes roping it off. Take me over the main street.
And yeah, like I don't know, like I just thought the whole game was just really fucking awesome. Like, there are even more games that I have held dear to me. Like, I have, like, a couple pages that I wrote in my phone about, like, wanting to, like, just record stuff about all these old games. Okay. Oh, whoops, shit. Okay, so... so, be a zoom in, be a zoom out. Okay. And this is how you can get some easy XP right at the start.
Whoa! What is that? Some kind of riot?
Yeah.
And see, like, this is what I'm talking about. Like, I loved this whole, like, opening of, like, looking at, like, all the craziness just happening. Trying to get a shot of him, like, getting grabbed. Oh, there we go.
Sure is.
And also, I remember the other cool thing that I loved about this game was, in the loading screens, you'd see your pictures that you took. So, like, all your erotic and all your, like, crazy pictures. Like, I love that. Like, it was such a cool feature back then that I really loved. And I thought that it was so, like, so game-changing in there.
Whatever's going on down there, it's not business as usual in this town.
Everything feels a lot quicker, too. And then also, too, like, just from, like, playing Dead Rising 1 then to number 2 and just seeing this game just change, just seeing it drastically change, like, from number 1 it being like we're only gonna be in a mall, to number 2 where it's like it's a bunch of malls like leading up with each other, and you know, it's just a little bigger mall in Vegas, because, you know, the whole Vegas thing. There we go. Ooh, baby, look at that. Oh, that was my favorite screenshot, like that one. That and even, like, taking pictures of the serial killers, that was such a cool thing, too. Or, sorry, not serial killers, psychopaths. Like, just this whole game, to me, felt like an iconic masterpiece. Because I love the music that they had for this game. I liked all the psychopaths. I liked the story. I love Frank West. Like, he's one of my favorite, like, characters on here. And then, like, later on and on and on, it kept getting better and better and better. And even number 3. Like, they still don't let Frank die. They're just like, man, he's still kicking. That's why Dead Rising 4, that's what I'm gonna be doing a Let's Play of. And I cannot wait for Dead Rising 4. Oh, that's gonna be sick. And the good thing is, too, is I have this game to tide me over, and same with Dead Rising 2 and Off the Record. And the other thing I thought that was super cool, too, about this was it was all single player. Like, that's what honestly made it, like, a really good thing. And then this dude's gonna spear this lady right off the edge. Caught it. I caught it. Yeah. That's awesome. Oh, that's awesome. I caught it. Oh, that zombie just speared the fuck out of that lady.
I want to see the center of town.
Oh, that's awesome.
Roger.
But yeah, no, like, this is just, this was the game that I was just like, I remember talking to my mom, and I was just like, hey, mom, like, I really want this game. Like, this game is awesome. Like, this is what I want to see. This is what I want to play. And even my mom was like, wow, like, a lot of this looked crazy at the time. And I remember, like, this and a couple other games I had.
Hey,
these were the games that I played the most. I played Vampire Rain because,
you gotta,
you know,
be kidding me.
A young kid as I was, man, was like, hey, this is gonna be super crazy, super cool.
Right,
and then the two other games that I remember playing the shit out of was this, and then BioShock.
It's Frank West. Remember that name, because the whole world's gonna know it in 3 days.
And Frank, the whole world did get to know. Like, that's what I love about, like, also talking about the whole, like, chain, like, leading up to stuff. Like, Frank gets, like, super famous because of it. Like, covering the story. And even though the more ridiculous this game became over the years, it was still great.
I'm gonna get my butt chewed out for this one.
And even like playing it now in like 2016.
We're going down.
Like it's still awesome. And to me, like, I still feel like the best, like, zombie game character to me would be Frank West. Because he is cocky journalist. Like, nothing against, like, Chuck Green from Number Two, but just Frank West is iconic. Like, when I think of zombie game,
you're
Frank
the reporter,
West.
Aren't you?
Yeah.
You.
With the signature, like, shitty,
yeah,
like, greenish pants.
You know. Go on the battlefield alone, no crew. So, what's going on around here anyway?
You came by helicopter, didn't you? What did you see from the sky?
Well, if it were just a riot, I doubt the military would quarantine the entire area. The moratorium on information getting out is a little extreme, in my opinion. There's, something else I can't put my finger on. Doesn't sound like civil disobedience. It's too quiet.
Almost as if everyone's already dead.
God, I have such a nostalgia boner right now.
So why don't you just tell me already? What's going on?
I think you'd better see for yourself. This, my friend.
Ooh, the cutaway. Oh, man, that looks great. Oh, that looks great, like brought to the Xbox One. Because you can, like, tell, like, he looks a little bit more oilier and everything. Oh, man, so good. Oh, it's so good. Oh, that's sick. But now that I get my couple minutes, because now I can just wait and be like, all right, here. This game was so good for the reasoning of how the zombies became what they were, to pretty much, like, everything, how it was. If you guys haven't seen it, or beat this game, this is a spoiler from years ago. This man right here, Carlito, who is probably, like, the craziest dude because of, like, his whole reasoning of doing what he did. Like, he is the main antagonist of this. And, like, he's so cool for what he did. And even though he was only in one game, he's super iconic. So I think we get all the DLCs here, and I probably will save when I find, like, a restroom or something. But I know life the fuck out of this game, people. Like, what I did, like, I remember getting every clothing item and every single thing that I could. Okay, yeah, so they did add all the DLC clothing.
Yeah.
Where was my signature suit?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I remember wearing the Men in Black one. Okay, yeah, because for me, I changed, or I had, oh shit, my bad.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, wait, and I remember how to save. I can save by just lying down. That's another thing I can do.
Yeah.
Sorry, everyone, I'm just looking for stuff. And also, too, like, to keep the conversation going, me and my friends had talks about, like, what was it called? Like, about this game, and then some other games coming out to play. And, for me, I was like, the game that I was looking super forward to playing was this. Because to me, I remember playing so many countless hours of this game. So many countless hours. So, like, to me, that's why I was super excited to see Dead Rising Collection coming back. Oh, wait, yeah, I forgot. There's another room over here. Ah, the good old fucking hub room. Oh, the good old room. Oh, it's so nostalgic coming back. Oh, it is so nostalgic coming back. Like, even though this game might look goofy to the younger age.
What in the world?
Of, like, people that see, like, that haven't played played this game. Like, it feels so nostalgic coming back. Like, man, I feel like how I was way back when. Oh, yeah, this was the suit that I wore. Oh, yeah, that was the suit. I forget what other ones there were.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's that one. Like they're all recolors, yeah. But... Alright, yeah, we're gonna wear this one. And then I remember each time you beat the game, there would be bags and bags and bags of stuff over here. Like, I had the Mega Man blaster that actually shot, like, the real rounds on here and then everything else. Like, oh, it's so nostalgic coming back. Like, I love this. Like, I love this feeling that I have of this. Like, it's so good. And even to the kids of nowadays that have not played Dead Rising 1 or the series, like, it's a really good fucking series. Like, I'd suggest, like, maybe, like, getting this version of it. Or, like, emulating it if you don't have it, because this is a game not to, like, pass up. Because it feels, like, super iconic and coming back. Like, it makes me feel like such an old man. Because, like, there's so many other nostalgic games out there, like Metal Gear 1 and everything else, but just seeing all this get revamped, it's like, oh my god.
See my baby! I can't so live good. Without my precious little sweetie doggy! Oh, where is my Madonna? Where is she?
Frank. Oh, I love Frank. Frank is good. He's the best. Like, I still love him as a protagonist. And then here is the second antagonist of the series.
Hey, this is no time to ogle pretty girls.
Oh, I love that, dude.
You looking to get yourself beaten alive by zombies?
What? Did you just say zombies?
Take a look out there. If those ain't zombies, what would you call
them? Those are zombies. Yeah, those are zombies. Oh my god, look at that.
There's been more and more of them since last night. Now, they're all that's out there. Eh, look on the bright side. Zombies are stupid and slow. We should be safe in here. All right then, feel like making yourself useful? Take a look around the mall. Bring anything we can use for the barricade.
I also like that they added time movement.
Andale, come on.
That's a thing that I don't remember in the original game, actually. So that's probably the whole, like, new thing. Like, they probably, like, added time movement, like, all this other, like, cool stuff. Oh, wait. Let me see. I should take a picture of these people.
He's probably hiding somewhere, shitting in his pants like a chump.
Good.
Fantastic. Good old Frank. There you go. Good. Take a picture of everybody while I can. Ooh, I got a peace sticker. That's another thing I forgot about. The peace sticker. There you go. Nice. And we'll take a picture of these two from afar. Because... that and... get him in an action pose. Also, I gotta remember too, like, I think that there's, like, a... I think that there's a picture that I can take right here. Oh, there it is. I see it. Can I not, like... I'd have to go upstairs. Alright, whatever. I'll come back to get that. Yeah, God, it feels nice to be walking the good old Willamette Mall. Because, yeah, legit, it's been forever since I fucking played Dead Rising 1. And I know in Dead Rising 4, they're gonna actually be bringing Willamette back. Because Frank West is the new character in it.
You! Stop right there! Do you have any idea what you've done? Why did you summon me to this place? What are you planning?
Would you calm down? I don't even know what you're talking about! What the...
But yeah, like, it's been so long. And, like, legit, like, I just fucking, like... I love that Dead Rising is just doing what it's doing. I mean, this is how everything goes to shit, because of goddamn dying. Because of goddamn poodle. You know, something really cool that I would say, I'd just throw her out there. And just walk the door, like, that's what I would've did. Like, these people were nice enough to be like, okay, lady, here, we're gonna grab the dog. I would've gave her the bum's rush and threw her out.
What in
the oh yeah, there's homie, doing? There's Brad.
Run!
Oh yeah, fucking
Quick,
Brad.
Move!
Fucking Brad.
Everyone,
oh, I love Brad.
Move this way! Quick! To the stairs! Move!
Man, this is good. Like, this is real good. Fucking Brad, man. Alright, here we go. Time to get my zombie smashing on. Oh, wait, okay. I need to... Okay. The sad thing is, too, you can't save any of these people, too. Like, they're kind of fucked from where they are. The fucking Zambos. Oh, shit. I forgot you take so much damage. Yeah, if you lose your health here, you get a cutscene where Brad drags you out, like, he kills a zombie, or kills some. And then actually, like, he'll drag you out, and everybody will be like, man, are you okay? Like, you just got your fucking ass handed to you. And it's like, to me, when I was younger, I would always try, like, killing all the zombies. Huh? That's what I always tried doing. Oh, yeah, there's the buddy Otis. Oh, yeah, there he is.
Where are the others?
I don't know. I hope they got away.
No. As long as those things are in the mall, we'd better not use this door.
And this is where they hash out the plan to, like, try saving people and, like, getting stuff. What are you
doing? The air ducts. They'll get us back into the mall. And apparently those things aren't smart enough to use the ducts. So they won't be a factor.
Wait a minute. You want to get back in there? What for? Hey.
Nice camera. Are you a photographer?
As a matter of fact, I am. Frank West, photojournalist.
Could you show me some just pictures,
Frank?
Just gets
shut down super hard. He's like, man, I want to give you a handshake. Yeah, I fucking love Frank. Like, he's the best.
You really seem to know what you're doing. Who are you guys, anyway? And what are you... I took that one near the entrance. That guy do something?
I love how Frank looks right now. Nope.
Thanks for showing me, though.
Oh, that's great. Oh, that's real good.
Hey, we're not done talking yet. Just who are you guys?
I'm Jesse. The man you saw earlier is Brad. That's all I'm authorized to tell you.
Yeah, aw, man, like, it's so good coming back. Like, it's so good. Yeah, and then we gotta talk to Otis. You ain't planning on going back out there. Good transceiver and a map, too. Honestly, what else would I do? Like, what else would I do? I know that back then, like, I remember, there was always, like, it wasn't a glitch, but it was, like, watch the couple hug and then take a picture of them. And I remember people would use that just to level yourself up. And to me, I was one of those people back then that would do that.
Hey, anybody around?
There we go. Get my munch on. There you go.
Good.
Have you seen my wife, Natalie? Look for somebody. I'll lend a hand. That'll be good fella. Or a great fella. My name's Jeff Meyer, by the way. I'm Frank. I'm a journalist. I'm the biggest dick zombie slang OG you'll ever fucking run into. Like, that fucking Chuck Green guy? You don't even exist yet. But here. Just for a shot. Look at all those Zambambis. Like, this looks nothing compared to Dead Rising 3. But still, you gotta think back then for this game. Like, man, that was crazy. Yeah, super crazy to see. Group photo. Okay, cool, there we go.
Mister!
I got your husband over here, lady. Oh, baby, there we go. Look at that. Fantastic.
Fantastic.
Boom, level up. Oh, yeah. And then each time you level up, you know, you get your attack, life, stock, throw, and all this other shit. So, yeah. Hey there, people. And each time you bring new people into the safe room, you get levels also, too. So there we go, cool. Let me see, is there anything else I really need? I guess not really. The one thing I can say I do remember having a fucking problem with on this game was, was trying to get people to actually follow you. Like, it can get pretty fucking annoying. Like, it's not bad. Like, they made this game super challenging to get, like, Frank's a pimp. That was one of the challenge where it was, like, get, like, 5 or 6, like, people to follow you. And,
Yeah.
Ooh, yeah. Cool, I got life up.
Yeah.
And that was one of, like, the super fucking annoying challenges. And achievements, because, you know, achievements are all the rage.
Right.
Yeah, fuck, we'll take this for now.
All right.
That ends, since I did this already, I guess I'm just gonna save.
What?
But yeah, I remember back when, like, playing through this, because I'd give you, like, so much XP right at the start. It's just, like, boom. Just keep, like, if you lose or whatever, just keep doing that. I remember having, like, a talk with one of my friends, and I remember him telling me that, he was like, man, like, I'm super not into leveling, like, all over again. And to me, it's like, man, that's kind of all the fun of Dead Rising, like, of each Dead Rising. To me. You can say it if I'm wrong, or if I'm not, but to me, the most fun about a Dead Rising game, sorry that I'm itching my nose, but yeah, the most fun about a Dead Rising game is more of the journey that you are going to be embarking on, other than, like, you know, like, let's say the camp, like, doing shit. Like, that's what I always loved about Dead Rising, like, compared to like a lot of other games. Like, I'm gonna bring up BioShock. Like, it's a linear game. Like, you can't just, like, mess around and do stuff. Okay. I'll give you a rundown of the mall. Yeah, the plaza. Yeah, take a restroom if you need to save. But yeah, sorry, no, to get that again. That's another cutscene. See, I don't mind this. Like, I don't have to talk.
Zombies, huh? Had a feeling you'd show up.
God, it's you. Look, don't sneak up on me.
Brad was attacked. I located him on the monitor. Ugh!
It's probably just a sprain.
I've gotta help Brad, or he's done for.
All right, fine. Give me your gun. Come on, I'm the reason you just got hurt. Let me help.
No, I can't let a civilian do that. That's against regulations.
Yeah, well, I don't think they had zombie-infested malls in mind when they wrote those regulations, kid.
You know how to use this?
Kinda.
There it is.
I've covered wars, you know.
Oh, there it is. That's the line I've been waiting for. That is the fucking line I've been waiting for. Oh, it's so good just hearing that again in all its glory. I've covered wars, you know.
Look, oh, that's good. After I'm through helping you, you and I are good. Gonna have a nice.
See, I hope in Dead Rising 4, I hope he says that line. I am looking forward to it. I am really looking forward to hearing him say that. And if he's not, that's a missed opportunity. But, I don't know what I should do. Like, unless if I can save somebody, let's see, what's this? Yeah, okay, it's a book. Yeah, peel item, whatever. So more times that I take a photo of a thing, like, I can get more of that. What's this? Item. Oh, holding things lasts 3 times as long. Let me just eat this. Holding on to the toys will last 3 times as long. So what was this one? Sporting goods. Oh, so it's fucking sporting goods. Ah, good old Dead Rising. Good old Dead Rising. What was this one again? To indicate prime photos. Oh, yeah, okay, yeah, no, I remember this. Okay, cool. Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, yeah, no, I completely remember that. Yeah, okay, that thing ain't really too great, but I'll keep it for a minute. Also, this is back when Oh yeah, I forgot I can't move the other stick. Yeah, I use the other one. Okay. Sorry, people, this is like trying to teach an old man new tricks. There we go. Get a funny shot. Oh, the kaboobie is right there. Boom, there we go. Perfect. And, I'm happy you still hurt me from that. Do I not have that yet? Okay. Because I know this is another way to... Oh my god, I miss having the kick. I miss having the kick already. People. This will take me a bit. Oh my god. Oh, this is brutal. Oh, this is brutal. Oh, fuck that. I can't do that right now, man. Oh, man. Okay, well. So, what we're gonna do is... To get used to the buttons. I'm gonna toss that away. And we're gonna go do what I remember me usually doing on this game. Drop all this crap, take a couple health kits, and then... Because the place where I have to go, I don't have to rush. Like, that's always been the beautiful thing of Dead Rising. Go. Get my katana. That was another good weapon to get somewhat early. And we got the gun. And for me, what I feel like doing is making some... Oh, wait, I remember. I think there's a pitcher on this. Oop, there we go. Fantastic.
Fantastic.
There we go. We got one of those, and I think behind this there might be one. Was it in one of these? Like I know, like, because remembering me playing this from way back when I was younger. There, like, in almost every place, there is a thing. Oh, there we go. Good old juicer. Oh, you'll serve me well. Ooh. Good. Just give me a second, sir. What was that? Oh, it was nectar. Good old nectar. Oh, you can stop that. Perfect. Fantastico. There we go. So, yeah, that's just another clothing store. I guess we'll use this to get along the areas. But yeah, I'm just, what I'm trying to do is just find where a couple of these things are from when, like I said, like I used to play this. Let's get the easy ones out of the way. Was there one on the Jill sandwich? I don't think there was. Oh, shit. I know I just missed one, too, on the other place where I was looking at. And the other place that I was looking at was the, what do you call it? It was the CD stand. The CD stand girl has a actual thing on her. It's Otis the janitor. You said you're a journalist, right? I've been watching on the monitors. Young guy wandering Paradise Plaza carrying a camera like you. I guess, he must be a photographer. I like this, and you are both crazy. And this is where we meet, not Brad, this is where we meet fucking... Cleared me a bit of room there. And this is where we meet our first psychopath. He is a photographer that knows Frank West, and obviously Frank don't know him, and the difference between why he's a psycho is, there's that signature laugh. Where is he? There he is, Kent. Fucking psycho over here. Oh, just point my gun directly in his face. Oof, drama. Good. You got a nice camera, blah, blah, blah. Like you're perfect. Ah, okay. I got a gun, too. Sorry, I'm just taking these pictures because it's free XP, so it's like, why not, you know what I mean? There, I think now we get a... Oh, okay. Wait, taking photos. Yep, I got it. There's brutal drama, erotic, all that stuff. Want you to take a picture of me while I show off. Okay.
Perfect.
That's no good, man.
God damn it.
Perfect.
Try a little harder, old-timer.
There you go. Fantastic shot.
Perfect.
I thought this was the one where he got into his karate kick move. A cool pose. Okay. Yeah, it's like, fuck, Kent. Sorry, I haven't been fucking on this game for a while. If you fail this, he doesn't give you the sleight of day. Boom. That's what I'm talking about. Oof, baby. Great shot. Mavada's still got the old fucking...
Over here, old man! Fantastic. Yeah, yeah. Keep it up, old timer. Fantastic. Over here, old man.
Yeah, dude, you are.
Perfect. Boring.
Well, I already took a picture of this thing.
Oh, yeah, great! Smile! Fantastic! I'll shoot you for real this time!
Robert, hold on to your guts.
Smile! Great shot!
Okay, I was reading that, man.
Good. Nice job!
Okay, I'm fucking up the pictures now.
Yeah, yeah. Keep it up, old.
Well, I think I already got his, like, perfect shot that he wanted.
Fantastic! Nice job! Damn it!
Shit, I don't want to read. Shit. No, pick that back up. You were fucking... There we go, you were a fucking slap chop right there.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's a nice
Fantastic.
Shot.
Boring.
Oh, fuck off, guy. I love that. He's like, oh, that's boring. Ugh. Okay, you're posing. I got you.
Fantastic.
Yes, you were in the...
I'll show you for real this time.
Fucking frame, man. You were there.
Perfect.
You were there, man. You were there.
Good. Boring!
So what, am I supposed to get him doing his, like, fist gesture?
Perfect.
That's mean.
You old sack of crap! Good. I'll shoot you for real this time!
Beautiful.
Fantastic.
It's gonna be a profile shot when I fucking kill you. They're gonna be like fucking this guy's dead.
Beautiful.
Boom.
Fantastic.
Oof, level up.
Perfect.
Not bad. Yeah. You did it. Oh, I got a skill. Oof.
Hmm. Well, it's in focus.
Yeah, fuck that. I'm a fucking real deal. I'm Frank West.
Uh-huh. Hmm. That ain't half bad.
Yeah, if you fuck up on this, he's like, hey, you know what?
Okay.
You suck.
Here comes the next one, Frank.
I'm gonna go out there and get better pictures.
Feast your eyes on my work. Now this is my most emotionally moving shot.
I have one of those.
Now this... is my sexiest shot. Okay. This is my most violent shot.
And you can just hear by, check like, fucking just doing this right now in his brain.
Okay, here's the deal, Frankie. You gotta go out there and take even better pictures than the ones
though.
I just showed you. Think you can handle that?
That's great.
Yeah.
So, what makes this dude a psycho, and this is why his picture is that color, is because he, like, there's two things that'll happen. One will be, you don't make it in time to stop him from trying to change somebody into a zombie. And when I mean change somebody into a zombie, I mean he's gonna, like, drop a fucking thing into the person's mouth to change them. Like, he's not a good guy. And even to spoil more, because I don't know if I will get to that part. Photo op challenge. Oh, so do I just meet him back here? Is that what I do? Oh, whatever. We'll go to barricade. But yeah, the biggest thing about him is that he just gets himself off about that. Just gives him a little bit of this. Get what I mean? And he's just, he's a big asshole. Like, to me, I don't like him as a psychopath because he's just, like, he's a dick. Let's put it like that. Because, like, after when I was younger and I played this, I was like, oh, you know, this guy's cool. It's like, maybe me and him will bro team and we'll, you know, maybe do stuff together. Like, it'd be like a sidekick character that takes after me type thing. No, he doesn't do it. He pretty much is like, hey, you know, Frankie, you didn't make it in time, so pretty much what I did is this, and he just shows you, and it's him shoving, like, or forcing a survivor to eat a infected worm, or something like that. It was an infected thing. So it forced that dude to pretty much, like, turn into a zombie. That's why that guy's a dick. The biggest reason that's why that dude's a dick.
Jeez.
Free fall achievement. Like, that's why I don't like him. He's a dick. And honestly, when you kill him, because you still are going to have to fight him, I think. Because there's also another thing, where if you, I think it's if you don't get there too, like, he ties you up and he tries, like, he takes a picture of you while you're in your underwear or some shit like that, and you have to fight him. So I think that's one of the things. Where you're gonna have to try to stop him that way. And I think, we're actually getting to our first psycho fight. I should have kept that katana, but I don't feel like running back and grabbing it. Yeah, you can, just how Kent is, he's a psycho, and, also the other people, like, let's say that haven't played this. I'm not gonna be like, man, you people, like, lived under a rock your entire life or whatever. But, yeah, like, there's so many unique and cool psychos for this game. That's what always made Dead Rising what it was for me. Over in the Les Plateaus. She's moving around awful lot. And, yeah, so I'm gonna have to go through here. Like, I'm gonna have to fight him. Yeah, so I'm gonna just go around here and fight that dude. But, yeah, the psychos were amazing. There's a butcher, there's Carlito, there's, like, all these, like, crazy dudes. Like, my favorite's probably the sergeant who you have to fight. And, another one I like would be the I forgot what his name is, like, the Huntsman, I think that's what people called him.
Your, girlfriend sent me to find you.
And pretty much, like, what he was, like, Jesse? This crazy Marine that went, like, damn insane it. After seeing, like, his daughter get, like, ripped apart by zombies, so he started thinking that he was a man,
you know how to use
and started,
gun?
Like, killing dudes and hanging them by the ceiling. Like, it was great.
All right, I'll cover you from here. You need to stick to the shadows. Try to get close to the target, okay?
And what am I supposed to do when I get close?
Well, that is, like, cool character. Like, I love it. He's just, like, giant.
But if you,
like,
can't do that,
Harrison Ford looking guy.
Keep him busy dodging your bullets.
That's wearing, like,
trouble.
Ripped up plaid up with, like, jeans.
I'm a lot better with a camera.
And he's so cool. Like, I like,
yeah,
I love
I'll
him.
Give it a
like,
shot.
He's probably my favorite psycho.
All right.
That still, Dead Rising has not
next
like tried
reloads,
to try to emulate or make that character
I'll lay down
again.
A suppressing fire.
Like, Dead Rising 3
I'm
had some good
on
ones. Dead Rising 2
make
had some
there.
Good guys, but to me. Oh yeah, wait, no, he was the machete guy, that's what everybody called him, or the machete man, and, his song was, like, really good. That's another thing, like, all these people had, like, super good songs. Brad, what the fuck are you doing down there, Brad? Come on now. Yeah, I might actually need to grab some health. I'm gonna fucking die if I don't. Oh, great. Oh, I forget where I grab health around here. Ice cream shop, I remember. Use the milk. There we go. Good. I forgot, it was always so weird how you aimed in this game. And also, too, this is back in the day when there wasn't fucking, like, auto-aim and, like, all this other stuff. Like, legit, you do what you do. Like, that's how this game was, and that's what honestly made it what it is today. Like, using guns in this game, to me, were actually the most fucking annoying things out there. Actually, I'm gonna grab a knife and see if I can go up there and stab him. Don't worry, man, I'm coming for you. A couple more caps, please. I don't know what this. Oh, untouchable. Carlito, don't run. Oh, I hope that fucking hurt you, son of a bitch. I got him. Oh, it's awesome. That fucking son of a bitch, Carlito.
Anyway,
I don't know. Well, thanks for your help. The name's Brad.
I'm Frank West, photojournalist. And right now, I'd rather have an explanation than your thanks, Brad.
Sorry. I've got nothing to tell you. Look. I don't know what Jesse told you. But as far as I'm concerned, we're through working together. So you cover your zombie story and leave the rest to us.
You guys are looking for someone here, aren't you? Hmm?
Who is that? Where did you take it?
You help me, I help you.
And see, that's the thing that I always loved about Frank. He always made things funny. Like Chuck had his funny quotes, and Nick was just... Like, the best thing about Nick was that he was awkward.
You're one hell of a journalist, aren't you, Frank?
But Frank, he had hilarity down to a T.
A hot-headed, underhanded, hotshot paparazzi with nothing better to do than to invade people's privacy.
That's journalism.
I try.
Brad, that's journalism. Man, that's journalism. The paparazzi is about getting all up in your business. That's how it is.
You win, Frank. Let's work together. Jesse and I are DHS agents. And yes, we are looking for the man in that picture.
You're with Homeland Security. Is that guy a terrorist or something?
Terrorists.
I took that picture in the entrance plaza. Right near the front door.
The entrance plaza. You're sure?
Hey! So do I have your permission to cover this story? Or not?
Frank. Oh, that's... Like, I love Frank. Like, Frank's the best. Like, that was always what was so, like, awesome about him, was just how he would act, and just every situation, and how he would drink bread. Frank is a man that doesn't need to lay bread down on toast or anything. He shoves it directly into his mouth. Like, watch this. You see this? This is corn on the cob. Let me just... Oh, just eat that raw. Like, I fucking love Frank. Frank's the best. There's just everything about him's good. Like, and also to get back with what I was talking about before, Nick was a good character because he was that kid. Like, even though that he actually, like, you know, wasn't an actual kid, he just had that whole persona of, like, hey man, like, I don't know what I'm doing here. Like, I don't want to be here. Like, that was Nick's entire persona. And they put it down to a T. That was the best thing about it. Like, they got Nick down to a T. And also, we need to get going because I forgot Brad can take damage over time. But yes, that was always the best thing that I liked about Nick Ramos as a character, who's the Dead Rising 3 protagonist. He was just awkward. Like, he had, like, this really, like, unsettling awkwardness, and it was perfect. Guess now we're in a store that I like. Oh wait, now there we go, let me get the sickle. I got that. Drop that. And let's take a shove, why not? Wait, can I break this open? Oh, shit. Oh yeah, I forgot, I gotta hold it. Perfect, there we go. And also just to show some cool stuff off that you could do on here. Jumping on each treadmill and just moving them. Yeah, I think Brad will be okay. Also, too, I can always make this into a, like, an actual series if I wanted to, because, like, I totally wouldn't mind doing this as a series. Like, it's been kind of on the part of my mind of me wanting to do it. Yeah, okay, Brad's okay. He's still in the picture. Looking back for those other people after. Perfect. All treadmills. I don't have the... I forgot I don't have any, what do you call it? Yeah, I don't have any pictures or other things to take pictures with. Shit. There we go, perfect. There we go, yeah. Stock. Stock Apu, all sandbags taken care of. I'm gonna see if I can actually pick that... Wait, I'm gonna see if I can pick you up. I don't know where she is. Christ, chill out. Can I pick you up? I wasn't gonna let you die here. Oh, there we go. Okay, I'm gonna pick her up. Well, okay, yeah, I forgot there is a thing. There's a thing showing that, hey, later at night, zombies will become more annoying. Yeah, zombies will become more annoying, and can I just skip that? Because I've seen this before. Like, pretty much all it shows is, like, boom, their eyes will be blood red now. But, yeah, that's a thing, though. Like, they do get a lot more hostile. Oh, wait, no, I'm gonna have to tell her to... Yeah, come on, ladies, go. Come on, lady. Jump over the fucking thing.
Follow me! Come on! Follow me! Follow
Perfect.
Me!
Okay, jump down. Let me just get my hustle on here. And then that's where I need to save the other dudes. And honestly, you know what? I'm debating on making this a two-parter because I'm enjoying myself so much. I do need to check the time after. No, it's only 10. Oh my god. Like, it feels like I've been playing way longer. Jeez. Okay. Don't worry, Brad. Sorry I had to save this broad. Yeah, let me see. Is that true? No, it's 11. Okay, yeah, sorry. No, it's 11. It is 11:50. Okay. But, yeah, we're gonna try saving her right now. And, yeah, this will probably be a two-parter. Because, yeah, I love playing this game. Like, this game's awesome. Like, I don't care how long it's gonna take for me to do shit. But, man, I love Dead Rising for what it is. Like, it's such a perfect game, like, to me. And a lot of people think that it's like, oh man, you know, like, oh, you're hyping up Dead Rising. Dead Rising didn't do so good in the later years, but it's like, oh, just this one. This one's got a special place in my heart, and I said that at the beginning. It has a very, very, very special place in my heart. Right here. Because that was when, honestly, the dream of, hey, wanting to record videos started to become a thing.
We can wrap this whole thing up.
No, I'm not leaving until you can guarantee me safe passage.
Until you open this gate.
Keep me safe passage. Just open this gate for your protection. I am not opening any gate. Thank you very much. I'm going to stay right here.
That's just like, eat a dick, sir. Eat a dick.
Dr. Barnaby?
I'm going to stay in this bookstore where there is no nutrients.
Well, what happened? You can't just arrest him?
He turned down my offer to protect him. Said he isn't going anywhere until I can guarantee a secure route out of here. Jesse has a direct line to HQ. The first thing we need to do is to call for backup.
Oh, also, another good character, seeing the movie thing back there. Another good, like, thing is the cult. Don't worry, lady, I'll pick you up. It's okay. Just on the phone here. Would you like one of the... Oh, okay. I guess you don't want anything. Shit, sorry. God, it's been a while. Oh yeah, I'm gonna have to tell her to get off my back. Okay, yeah. Oh, don't worry, lady.
Thank you very
it's all
much.
Good. I'm gonna have to run your ass through that, and I think this is when the,
Thank
I think this is when the dickheads
much.
Start to spawn. The, yeah, the other dudes that are kind of annoying to fight spawn, and they keep spawning. The psychopaths that are, I forget what their, like, actual names are, but they're pretty much the prisoners. And that's gonna be a problem. I really hope that the prisoners who stole the Hummer aren't going to be there. So to me, I feel like I'm just gonna take her over. And also, I can get a good gun in this pond right here. That's the MAC-10. But I'm gonna save that for a rainy day, because the MAC-10's a good gun. And another thing, with good guns, they don't respawn back. So... Excuse me, to be honest with you, it's good just trying to save that for, let's say, like, a hard boss that you're gonna fight. For me, I'm just gonna run past it. Let me see, can I actually get these dudes, like, over here? I'm gonna see if I can do that.
Thank you very much.
Get over there.
Over there!
Oh my god. You know what? Yeah, no, this ain't worth it right now. She's got a bum leg, and, yeah, no, this ain't worth it. No, it's fine. It's fine, lady.
Follow me!
It's fine. I'm gonna have to get something to eat, so...
Thank you very much.
Get some potato chips. Oh, fuck, we're gonna have to leave those guys behind. We're gonna have to leave them behind for now. For now. If they die, they die. Honestly, I'm not doing a perfect run. And that's the other thing is, too, like, there's so many other channels out there in this giant internet space that have probably done perfect runs. And for me, it's just, you know, I've done my time with this game. It's just nice to play over again. I should bring food. That's the thing that I am probably going to need to... Yeah, we'll bring wine. Why not?
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Wine should be good for either me or you. And yeah, fucking Kent right there. Ah, fucking Kent. To me, the biggest dick. The biggest dick. Yep, there you go. The fucking psycho is my favorite. I love these dudes. I fucking love these dudes.
You missed, loser! Get your aim right, brother!
And for me, I don't have the thing to kill these guys, so... I'm gonna try my best to maybe fight them. I can always try coming back and picking her up, too. That could be another thing. But yeah, I love these guys, and the song that they have is so iconic. Yeah, we're going. Yeah, I fucking love this song. It's so classic. This and the Machete Guys song. There they are. But they got stuck.
Thank you very much.
Let me see, is he gonna try running into me again? If he is, I'm gonna fuck him up.
Thank you very much.
Fucking number, we're just gonna go. Yeah, we're just gonna run her out of here and I'll fuck these dudes up after. Come on, lady. That was the best. I skid away from those dudes. Every time, I remember when I was younger and I played that, everybody got messed up. Like, it was such a bad time. Okay, I'm gonna spam that line.
Come on! Follow me! Follow me!
I would like to get a picture of these two, so I'm gonna, like, drop her by the,
thing. Follow me! Come on!
And yeah, that is annoying, but we want her to keep following. Bert Thompson is dead. Yeah, that dude just died. Oh. Ah, shit. Wait, no. Those are the bros. I forgot. Ah, whatever. Fuck it. This ain't a perfect run, so.
Follow me! Come on!
Carrying, like, all those people over here? Fuck that.
Come on!
There you go, perfect. We might have to fight our way through here, so I'm just probably gonna run. But yeah, honestly, though, like, that's kind of the hard thing about this, like... Damn. Oh wait, no, we don't have to walk through here. I forgot, this is introducing the mechanic of the bee, because that was the way how the zombie infestation, actually became a thing. And this is just showing it's like all right here. Stomp on the bee, and then the zombies are gonna die.
hell is going on around here?
And then pretty much that's just showing, hey, the bees are the cause of it. So they have new people that are showing.
Come on!
Yeah, wait, you know what? Here, I'm gonna kill this guy over here. The good thing I can say is, hey, at least I got two people. There we go.
Perfect. Done.
Perfect.
Come on! Follow me!
Gonna have to go back and pick her up. No, wait, let me see. Lady, since you're a little ragged here, I'm gonna top you
off.
Thank
you very much.
Good.
Since you're a little messed up, now I can actually pick you up, and here we go. But yeah, no, see, that's the annoying part. It's like, if you get this quest, then the other dude's quest, god, it's annoying. Like, it's super annoying. Because, getting all those people along while those dudes are gunning at you, it's a fucking bad time. It is a real fucking bad time.
Thank you very much.
Go!
And, because, like, with Leia, you have to carry her, and then the other two dudes you have to grab. So, like, it can just be super annoying. I'm just gonna get a good picture.
Perfect.
There. There, at least I got two ladies now in there, too, so I have four people. And, yeah. And there, now I have free time to do whatever. At this, and this is, might be where I just turn things off.
So that's what Dr. Barnaby said, huh?
The old coot's not dumb. He wants us to call for help first. We gotta line out or what?
The signal's being blocked. I can't even contact HQ on the emergency line.
So, if we want to get our hands on Dr. Barnaby, we're gonna have to secure a way out of here ourselves. All right, we've got to deal with the situation we've been handed. The boneheads back at HQ might be working on something, too.
There's a helicopter coming. 3 days from now. At noon, it's my ride.
Is your ride reliable?
Absolutely. That's how I plan on getting out of here.
All right, then. I'll see to it that the DHS picks up the charter fee. Can we take Dr. Barnaby as well?
Sure. As long as you tell me what's going on.
Okay. I'll tell you what you want to know. Later. We have more pressing business right now. If we have to wait here for 3 days, we'll need supplies. Water, blankets and the like. We'll get Dr. Barnaby here tomorrow morning. I want you to keep an eye on the monitors.
Frank's just like, man, the only thing I need is that couch in there. There you go, master another skill. Flying dodge. There we go. That's the ability that I always love because you just, you roll. You constantly roll, and that's the best part about it. So, yeah, there we go. So, I hope you guys enjoyed. Subscribe and become a friend today, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. So stay awesome, guys. Okay, wait, sorry, I pressed the wrong button. Alright, see you guys in the next one.